Firstly, of course, as I was saying at the time of inauguration today as well, we are delighted and proud, happy to welcome Goldman Sachs into Hyderabad. As Gunjan pointed out, our conversation began last year in September, I think it was. In fact, initial conversation, initial discussion was centered around how they had multiple locations of choice, etc., and how they were also evaluating Hyderabad. But once they decided on Hyderabad, in fact, I should point out the initial number that Gunjan had mentioned to me, number of employees that would be placed in Hyderabad, was only 500 initially. But in the last, I think, 6, 7 months, or more recently, in fact, what has happened is the kind of response, the kind of talent pool there is, and the kind of infrastructure there is in the city has definitely motivated them, correct me if I'm wrong, into thinking that they could launch a bigger operation here. And today, I'm happy. Today, when I walked in, Gunjan told me that initially we said 500, but we are looking at 2,500, almost quintupling what the initial estimate was. So my compliments to the entire team of Goldman Sachs for your choice of a location and for continuing to repose faith in Hyderabad, in India, even in the midst of this pandemic. Because a lot of technology companies, a lot of financial services companies, contrary to the popular perception, have been growing rapidly. But I think they have been growing in locations of their choice, in places where they can build a long-term kind of partnership. So not only Gunjan, but I would also like to thank David Solomon, the Chairman and CEO of Goldman Sachs, who had also joined us virtually. I'd like to thank him, and eventually, hopefully, we'll also have him come down to Hyderabad to India. What I would also like to point out to Gunjan and to all of you also is the banking, financial services sector, and insurance services sector in Hyderabad has been growing at a rapid pace. If you look at the last few years, some significant investments have come in. Since I'm sitting in Goldman's office, I don't think it would be very prudent to reel out. I already have, but I think doing it a second time would not go well with Gunjan, so I'd rather not do that. A lot of investments have flown in the last few years. Almost 180,000+ employees are currently working in the BFSI sector alone, which is a remarkable number, if you ask me, because for a sector such as this, to have such a large number in a city like Hyderabad is a telling comment on the ecosystem and the strength that the city has to offer. So I welcome Goldman Sachs, and I am very confident, because I loved a couple of their initiatives I was sharing with them on the stage as well. The whole 10,000 women initiative, to create 10,000 women entrepreneurs from India, I think it's a laudable initiative. Launched, I think, with the support of ISB and IIM Bangalore. I request Gunjan Samtani to work and his team to work with our V-Hub here, the Women Entrepreneurs Hub. I think we complement each other. I think there's a lot of synergies to be explored. I would request you to kindly start a cohort program right here in Hyderabad in tandem with V-Hub. We could also, in fact, do a lot more together. I loved what you said about emerging technologies and how you continue to invest significantly on the innovation front in emerging technologies. Even Telangana as a state, in fact, has also been leveraging all kinds of emerging technologies, including AI, ML, robotics, blockchain, all of these. In fact, even in the government sector, not only as a policy to promote investments, but also in the government sector, we continue to invest heavily into these new technologies and emerging technologies. So I request you again to work with us. And on innovation front, in fact, we have India's largest technology incubator, which all of us are quite familiar with, the T-Hub. Now, again, T-Hub can potentially complement you in your efforts to run a possible corporate innovation program where we could work with you, identify some pain points in the financial services sector. We could create a program. We've done that for other sectors. For example, in aviation and aerospace, we've ran a program with Boeing called as Horizon X, where Boeing threw a corporate innovation challenge at T-Hub, and T-Hub could float a digithon of sorts and invited lots of young minds to collaborate and come out with solutions. And we came out with some really brilliant solutions. I would also like to point out, innovation and startups in the financial services sector are also doing really well. In fact, HiRadius, I think it is a unicorn out of Hyderabad. in financial services sector, which is a startup incubated in Hyderabad. So it's not only large enterprises like Goldman Sachs who are making Hyderabad choice of their location, but also new age companies, startups, technology, providers for that matter. All of them coming together is what will make Hyderabad more robust in terms of an ecosystem. And once again, my thanks to Gunjan for quintupling the number from 500 to 2,500. And I'm very confident. He said 2023. मुझे तो उम्मीद है कि इससे पहले ही हो जाएगा क्योंकि हमने बहुत बार ऐसा देखा है इससे पहले भी जब भी कोई नई कंपनी आती है वो कहते हैं कि हमें दो साल में करना है तीन साल में करना है बट मुझे पूरा उम्मीद है कि एक साल में आप ये प्लेस जो है भर जाएगा फिर आप फिर आगे हमारे पास वापस आओगे और कहोगे कि मुझे एक मिलियन स्क्वायर फीट या कुछ और चाहिए एक ऐसी जी ऐसा कुछ चाहिए तो आई सिंसियरली बिलीव एंड स्ट्रांगली बिलीव दैट दिस इज अ प्लेस विच रियली एनकरेजेस innovation encourages entrepreneurship. So welcome to Hyderabad, welcome to Telangana. We are a long-term partner with you. We'll continue to, be your partner in your growth story. Thank you very much for this opportunity.